Hi, it's Rich. Welcome to my blog. Happy New Year. Hey, so if you were going to look into the flat Earth theory, first of all, why the fuck would you do that, right? Flat Earth, are you fucking crazy? That's nuts. Flat Earth. Somebody wrote to me and said, "Hey, Rich, what do you think of the flat Earth theory?" And I thought, nothing. What the hell is this? Well, who knew? There's a big buzz going on about flat Earth. So after the third viewer wrote in and said, "Rich, what do you think of the flat Earth theory?" I go, "Well, I guess I should look into it and think something." So I looked at it. I go, that's interesting. Yeah, that doesn't add up. Yeah, how come people can see so fucking far? Hey, wait. Sailing ships can see lighthouses like way far away. They're not supposed to be able to see that. That's supposed to be over the horizon. What's up with that? Yeah. So that was one. They got these new the Nikon P600, I think it's called. It's a super zoom, 82x super zoom camera, movie camera. And you can zoom out over the horizon, like on the ocean. And ships are like smaller than a speck. You can't see them until you zoom in, and then you can see them. And they should be over the horizon. I mean, without getting into any of the details of the numbers and the math and the how far you can see over the horizon and all that stuff. I just want to give you some broad concepts and thoughts and things that I've seen that made me want to look deeper into this flat Earth theory. Another big one has to do with the sun. And I don't know about you, but I've noticed it many times over my life that sometimes the sun looks big and sometimes it looks small. And I figured, well, yeah, it's just the way it's going over the horizon, it's going far away. And it's going over the horizon. So, yeah. Smaller. Sure. But it's been pointed out as an argument. If the sun is 93 million miles away and huge, like this size, and Earth is like this size, and see how small Earth is? It's like a BB. And I guess the sun is going to be up like this, right? BB. Now imagine you are standing on the Earth sideways. This is the top, but you're over here because the sun's over here. Let's move the whole fucking thing like this. You're up here, and you're standing on the little BB down here. This little fucking BB. You see over here? Oh, and here's the sun. 93 million miles away. Huge, but 93 million miles away. If we did the math, how big should that really look? Does it look as big as our sun looks? Is it that big? Or should it look smaller? Well, I don't know, man. Anyway, if it's that far away and the Earth goes, it turns a little bit, so now this is the sun is at sunset. See how little you just move that much? That much? I don't think the sun should look smaller. Okay. I don't think so. So I'm going, yeah, what about that? Of course, there's going to be a science explanation for every one of these arguments. Whether you're gonna buy them or not, that's up to you. But one was, oh, it's an illusion. It just looks smaller because when it's closer to the horizon, blah 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 blah. I go, well, now watch the video. This guy, time lapse. He's got the tree line here, sun's here at noon or something, and then it doesn't move the camera all day, and then the sun sets over here and it's smaller. So then just grab that little piece, move it up here, and you compare it to the sun when it was here to here. You know, you're not changing the size or scale or anything. It's just, you know, I've played a lot with special effects and Photoshop and video editing and all this stuff. So yeah, it's a no-brainer. And you just move that up to there, and the sun is definitely smaller. And I go, okay, question. At 93 million miles away, and you spin the Earth, and see, you're not spinning the Earth from high noon over to sunset like it was like at one quarter of the circumference. We can only see, our horizon is only like 3.5 miles. Three and a half, 4, 5, 6 max, right? So the sun, we're only going to move just a little bit. Or is that, no, that's wrong think, I think. Yeah, we're gonna have about 6 hours of rotation. 6 hours of rotation, okay. But yeah, I'm not the math wizard, so that's why I'm not talking about the math too much. I'm just looking at the common sense of all this. So anyway, another compelling thing to look at, if you do your own observations on this and question this stuff, is the moon and how it eclipses and moon shadow relative to the sun. What happens when the sun is in the sky and the moon is in the sky? Theoretically, you will have an accurate shadow. You're down here on Earth and you can see the sun here and you can see the moon over here, and there should be an accurate shading on the moon. This shine should be lit and that side should be dark, and you should be able to see the shadow line. It doesn't add up sometimes, maybe, but it doesn't always add up. So it's just something to look at. It's like, it's really, for me, hard to come up with the absolutely fucking nail it compelling documentation evidence that confirms it for me. I'm still looking for that. I still have questions about, if it's flat, how come this? If it's flat, how come that? It has to do with the stars and the sun and stuff like that. Okay, but here's another thing to look at that I find, I'm going, yeah, what about that? That doesn't make sense. And it's like, here's the ground, here's the cloud cover. It's just broken clouds. It's got a few holes in it. And the sun's up here. And we all look, do it. We look up at the sky and we see the sun rays breaking through the clouds. And we literally see the rays. And they go like this. There's a trajectory outward. So they like that. Well, the logic is that the sun is way bigger than Earth, and the sunlight going this way is going to be a straight sunbeams, because the Earth, you know, it's just BB, and this is a huge sun. So even if you move this way far away, the sunbeams are still going to be, relatively speaking, parallel. So if it breaks through cloud cover, it's like little bitty tiny cloud cover, it shouldn't be spraying out in all different directions. If it's doing that on Earth, little bitty Earth here, and the cloud cover's here, and the sunbeams are going this way, and the sunbeams are going this way, you just draw a line, trajectory lines, and you will, where it intersects would be where the sun is. Seems like, logically speaking. And so when you look up in the sky and you see the sunbeams coming down and they go, And there's artists, there's drawings and paintings. It's a glorious picture, really. You go, oh, that's so beautiful. Well, it's like that. If you're on Earth and a little bitty Earth here and big old giant sun here, but it's a million fucking millions of miles away, 93 or something, and then and you got the sun rays going boom, 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 you do draw a trajectory and you will find, you'll calculate where the sun is. That ain't right. And the first thing you do, because you're so, we're so programmed and so well educated on the sun being way far away, that we start looking for errors in our thinking or errors in our perception. If we're thinking, we're looking at the sun and we're seeing these beams come out, we start thinking scientific reasons why it's not what it obviously looks like, right? There's too much of that shit going on. There's too much of this, what you see is one thing, and what we're told is another. And what all of society and the world believes is one thing, and what we're seeing is another. So we're believing what we've been told instead of what we perceive on a massive scale. And it's really hard to break this one because it's so prevalent. Everybody's saying. Everybody's given us an explanation of how this is globular Earth and why things look the way they do. But when you look at the details, like the moon shadow, sun, moon, Earth, the shadow's in the wrong freaking place. Not always, sometimes. What's that? The sun rays are coming out of the wrong fucking way. What's, that's not right. It shouldn't it be? Hmm? And the sun gets smaller as it moves away from you. If it's closer to us, like these sunbeams would indicate, the trajectory would indicate how far it is. And I think with a little bit of math sense, a person could, and lining up the angles, measuring the angles of these sunbeams as they break through the clouds, somebody could do the math and figure out how far the sun is from the Earth from that perspective. And I think it was done, some guy back in the, you know, 300 AD, I don't know, some guy back there did that just by planting sticks in the ground at high noon here and then way over here. Anyway, it's a fascinating subject. It gets interesting. All of a sudden, there might be something to this flat Earth theory. So I personally find it a little frustrating because I can get so close to that last thread of evidence that goes, yep, I'm on board, man. I'm totally on board. Flat Earth, you got it. Absolutely. I haven't gotten there yet. I'm still looking, though. It's a very engaging research project. Another very interesting thing is airline flights. Short story is North Pole center of our flat Earth map, and everything else kind of spreads out. And so, for example, from Perth or Sydney, Australia, over to South America on a globe, you'd think that the jet would fly from here to here. If you spread this thing out, the jet's going to fly, if it's on a flat map, it'll fly over different parts of the world. It's the long way around, and logically a jet wouldn't do that, a passenger liner wouldn't do that. They'd take the shortest route-ish, have to consider refueling. But when you look at the flights and lay down, some guys have done this, they laid out the flights. Literally, you can get on orbits or cheap flights or whatever, and you can find out what the flights are, how many miles are covered, and what their layover is, or if they start here, go here, then go here. And when you look at all that evidence and get involved in it, you're going, yeah, it supports the flat earth theory. It's not conclusive evidence because anybody could say, well, the jet goes from Buenos Aires to the UK and then back down the other side of the equator because it's got to pick up more passengers. They can come up with, there's any number of reasons you could explain away the jet path, flight paths. So it looks good, but it's not conclusive, and it's not always, it's not always working for us. So this is why I say, for me, it's frustrating. But I'm still looking for the answers. And why I think this is important is that if we do have a flat Earth, and I think it's quite possible that we do, very possible, then it will be that thing that can be proved more easily than these other things that are going on that people will find hard to believe about what's going on planet Earth. And if people come to find out that we're being lied to about the Earth, it will cause them to look at who's doing it and why and how long this lie has been perpetrated on us. And it will make people look at who could possibly want to do that and why. And so for me, the whole flat earth theory is an excellent wake-up call for anyone with the least bit of curiosity or desire to know and understand the truth of what's going on planet Earth. So I encourage everyone, if they haven't done it yet, look into this flat earth thing, and you're going to find problems with the globular earth theory. You're going to find anomalies that are answered where it makes sense if it's a flat earth and the sun is closer than we're told it is. And things are not what we were told, but there's new theories on what's going on and why are things the way they are and how this flat earth thing works. Okay. Now, theoretically, it'd just take a little more time. And if the earth is flat, we're going to figure it out. I mean, plenty of people have figured it out for themselves, and they're absolutely know for themselves that the Earth is flat. And some people are absolutely know that it's not flat, but it's this way, or it's, but it's not a globe. Some people are there. Of course, many are not. And many people are on the path of sorting it out so that they do have clarity and understanding on one way or the other. But there's just too many anomalies, man. There's too many things that don't add up when you really look at this subject. So I highly recommend everyone take a closer look and start doing their own research and their own experiments, their own math. And if you find some really good conclusive stuff, make some videos about it. I'm going to make some more videos about it too. And this is just a chat it up and a kick it around starter thing for people who haven't really looked into it before. This isn't the video for people who have really looked into it and did the measurements and the calculations and the video and the analyzing sun patterns and moon and sun positions and sizes and distances. This is not a video really for people who have gotten that far into it. Okay, this is more of a, hello, you might want to check out this flat earth theory because, something's weird. Oh, last little weird is like, yeah, but what about all NASA and all the photographs and all the astronauts and all that? Come to find out, most of those astronauts are Freemasons. Documented evidence. Freemasons. Which would explain how they are part of the big story. They would know the difference. They would know the truth of it because they get beyond far enough away. And so why wouldn't they be coming out with it? Because they are part of that brotherhood that is involved in the perpetuation of the lies that are going on planet Earth. Okay, enough said on that right now. Okay. That's all for now. Thank you for watching. And if you got some great video evidence or a great YouTube video that you found or that you've made, yeah, go ahead and put your links here in the comments and stuff. And I'd be glad to look at them. And I'm sure other viewers would too. All right. Okay, I got to go. I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching.